C4.
And Bryan Nehman.
WBAL News Radio 1090.
FM 101.5.
And the WBAL mobile app.
Good morning. Happy Monday. Bryan Nehman, Dan Joseph in for C4 this morning. We're pleased to be joined now by Barry Glassman, Harford County Executive. Good morning, sir. Always good to have you on.
Good morning.
So we were just talking about, you know, the gas tax and it not being extended. Overall, your thoughts not only on that, but also on the 90-day legislative session in Annapolis and how you thought it went and how it impacts the counties and specifically Harford County.
Well, I think I may have done a more gradual summertime implementation of that gas tax reduction, kind of a bell curve up and down. Instead of just dropping it on and dropping it off in 30 days. So I think it definitely should be extended a little bit further. Maryland counties did okay during the session. I don't think, particularly on the gas tax, you know, Bryan, I've talked to C4 over the years as president of the Maryland Association of Counties. We've tried to get our local highway taxes back for our road maintenance and serving, and we ended up with a very small increase to last us 2 or 3 years, but most counties are still about 80% below their revenue, and the state still kept it. So we did okay. We got some better reimbursements for our ambulance services, Medicaid reimbursements, but for the most part, it was pretty much a mixed bag for us this year.
Executive, you're calling your budget for fiscal year 2023 historic. Why is it historic?
Well, you know, and this is my last budget. I've spent 8 years, and we've kind of taken the county from a $3 million surplus, one that was struggling at the end of the last big recession, and employees had not had raises for 7 years. We in Harford County came out of a real tough time, but through a lot of economic development and efficiency, we did cut back in those early years. We've kind of brought ourselves to the point where we're strong enough to not only fully fund education, we have always tried to fully fund our public safety, which we did in this budget, but got to the point where we could give our local citizens a tax break, too, and a full nickel, which is the most in county history. So, and I would say at the same time, keeping a $30 million fund balance and a 5% rainy day fund. So it's an historic budget as well as it is, and really as strong as it is, which relates to our local economy, too.
So you're running for comptroller, and we all know what the situation is in Maryland when it comes to Democrats outnumbering Republicans. What is it going to look? There are a lot of people believe this is going to be a giant wave in November. So from your point of view, what does it take to have an upset? Because we all know it'd be an upset for a Republican to win at the state level. It has to take something special from the candidate, something special from the turnout or whatever. What do you see as the possibility when it comes to Republicans in November, in general terms as well as your own race?
Yeah, for our race, Bryan, I think it clearly, folks, taxpayers, whether you're a Democrat, Republican, or independent, you know, one, a fiscal trustee, somebody that's proven and trusted. And, you know, I've got a long history, not only in the private sector, but in the state Senate and as county executive, showing that I can do that. So I think for comptroller folks, taxpayers want to look at that more so than a partisan line, whether you're a Democrat or independent. And in Harford County, I've had support from all three, Republican, Democrat, and independent. So I think I've got that kind of crossover appeal and common sense that folks want when they pick a person to sit on the Board of Public Works and do revenue and so forth. So I think, you know, I've got that kind of background. So we feel pretty good, even in a normal year, that we appeal across the board. Certainly right now, when you look at energy cost, inflation, and a number of things that we've been through, I think the wind, if you're a Republican, the wind is at our back a little bit. But, you know, I think you still have to be experienced and talk about what folks really want you to talk about for that particular position. But, you know, I'm also been around long enough to know that 6 months is a lifetime in politics.
Yeah, right.
Things can flip around And you know, it could be totally different here in November. I'm fortunate not to have a primary, so we've been already traveling the state, and we'll keep doing that all summer, no matter who our Democratic opponent might be here during the summer.
Very good. Always great to have you on. We appreciate you coming on, especially in the 6 o'clock hour. You know, not many people will get up that early for
thank
us.
Thank you.
Mr. County Executive.
We've got a frost up here, and then I heard gosh. C4 wasn't in, so you tell him I was looking for him.
I will. Very good. We'll talk to you down the road, all right?
Thank you.
Take care.